Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach you Unit 2 of EMF. It is electrostatics. Okay. So in this unit, I am going to teach you the electric field and its components. Okay. Electrostatic means the static electric field and its components. Okay. Study about that. Okay. So in that, first we will see Coulomb's law. Okay. Coulomb's law. It is the law of force that is acting between two point charges. Okay, so let us consider point charges Q1 and Q2 that are separated by a distance r. Okay, so Coulomb's law states that the force acting between Q1 and Q2, it will be along the line joining the two points, and it is directly proportional to the product of the two point charges, and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay, so this proportionality can be written as K, and this is the constant of proportionality, and K is given as 1 by 4 pi epsilon. Okay, so here epsilon is the permittivity of the medium. Okay, so this epsilon can be written as epsilon naught into epsilon r. Epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space, so it is a constant, it is given as 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 Farad per meter. Okay, and epsilon r is the relative permittivity. Okay, okay, so this is the general form of Coulomb's law. Now let's see the Coulomb's law in vector form. Vector form means we have to write it in direction, we have to consider the direction also. Okay, so let's say, right, the force that is acting at point 1, from point 1 to point 2. Okay, so that means we are considering one direction. Okay, so F, that is from F 1 to 2, what is the force? It is Q1 into Q2 divided by the constant 4 pi epsilon into R1 to square. Okay, so the difference is here we have written R square, here R1 to means we have considered the direction. Okay, from 1 to 2. Okay, and for vector form we have to mention the unit vector also. Then only we can say that the vector is vector. Okay, so the unit form is AR1 to vector, from 1 to 2. Okay, so unit vector, how the vector form is identified? So just from this diagram only we have to write the unit vector. How? Let's say Q1 and Q2 be the two point charges separated by r, a distance, and we have to calculate the r of the distance from its origin. Okay, so say for example, in the coordinate system, and with respect to origin, what is the distance of the point charge Q1? Okay, so let it be R1, and again from the origin to Q2, it is R2 vector. Okay, from this you calculate the unit vector. So basically unit vector is nothing but the vector divided by the magnitude. Okay, so the vector means the distance between R1 and R2 and its magnitude. Okay, so this is the unit vector. Okay, so this is the vector form of the Coulomb's law. Now, what is the relationship between F1 and F2? Okay, I mentioned F1 means from F2, what is the force? From F1 to F2, what is the force? F2 means from F2 to F1. Okay, so these two forces are equal but in opposite direction. Because of that only we have mentioned a negative symbol here. This denotes both are equal but opposite directions. Okay, so what happens if more than one or two forces are acting? That means more than two point charges are used. Say for example Q1, Q2 up to Qn charges. Okay, in that case what we will do, with respect to origin, we will calculate each and every forces separately. Okay, so the total force is nothing but the cumulative or the sum of all the individual forces. And what will be the relation between F1 and F2 now? F1 is equal to minus nF2. That means n times, there are n point charges, n times the force of the other. Okay, so that's all about the Coulomb's law. Now let's see Gauss law. Okay, so this is the second electrostatic law, which is Gauss law. Gauss law states that, okay, so this is the smoothest equation of Gauss law, it is phi is equal to q. Phi usually it is flux. Okay, so Gauss law states that the total electric flux, okay, over a surface will be equal to the total charges in it around the surface. Okay, so total flux. So it is almost not possible for finding flux in real time. What we do is, for particular surface, we'll calculate the flux and we'll try to integrate over the entire surface. Okay, so for order to find the flux, we use a density, flux density. Usually density means what? Per something, per unit something, what is the count? Okay, so for the B is electric flux density. Electric flux density means per unit area, how much number of fluxes are there. Okay, so we'll first find D and we'll integrate it over the entire surface. We'll get the phi. Okay, so this is the mathematical form of Gauss law. Gauss law states that the total electric flux is equal to the total charge around the surface. Okay, so in order to prove this Gauss law, let us take as one point charge Q. So this is the point charge Q, and we'll take a Gaussian surface around the point charge. Okay, so for analyzing this, it is convenient to take spherical coordinate system. Why? Everything is in spherical form, so because of that, it is convenient to use spherical coordinate system. Okay, now, so let us assume a Gaussian surface over the point charge, and from that surface, we will take only a unit surface, that is a small surface. Let D be the flux that is coming out from this small surface, that is your D. Okay, so for this surface, we will analyze and we will integrate it over the entire surface. Okay, so from this point, okay, from this particular point, the flux lines are moving in the direction of AR. In spherical coordinate system, AR means in radial direction. Okay, alright. So in this, from this diagram, you have to write what is D and what is DS. Okay, so this is the main thing, what is D and what is DS. Okay, D means what? So this is the flux. We know from the diagram, so we can say D is only along our direction. Okay, we don't have any component in other direction, only our direction. So D can be written as DR into AR. Similarly, what is DS? DS means it's a surface. Just recall the surface area of spherical coordinate system. How will you find? Just write the components dr or d phi or sine theta, or d theta or sine theta d phi. So these are the three components. And if it is in r direction, we'll just take the r and we'll multiply these two. So that is r square sine theta d theta d phi. R square sine theta d theta d phi. And we have to mention the direction also. In which direction? R direction. Okay, alright, so we got D and DS, just substitute in this equation to prove it. So let's write the Gauss law, Q is equal to D dot DS integration. So we just substitute D and DS there. Okay, and here we have the dot here, that means we have to perform dot product. Okay, dot product between two vectors. Where are the vectors? AR dot AR. AR dot AR is nothing but 1. AR dot AR equal to 1. Okay. So we can skip that. So we can write a reminding things. Here DR and R are what? Constant. Because there is no differentiation term. We don't integrate with respect to R. Okay. We don't integrate with respect to R. So we can take it out outside as a constant one. So DR and R square can be kept aside. And integration. Let's see. D theta. D theta ranges from 0 to 5. So in the spherical coordinate system itself, you have seen D theta ranges from 0 to 5 and 5 ranges from 0 to 2 pi. Right? So just write the limits also. Now we perform the integration and substitute the limits. Right? So theta integration is minus 5. Okay, so here also we'll apply the limits.